And now you guys hear all of this commotion going on outside because there seems to be something going on. But you guys had drank so much that, you know, you're a little bit more hungover than most. So you wake up and you hear, you know, a lot of people talking and stuff outside. What do you guys want to do?
I would go out.
I probably would too.
I kick open my door and shut up!
Uncle, be quiet!
Sorry, Magnus.
And then I wander. I'm just wearing my underclothes.
Somebody passes by you and just says, I think the Jarl's going to kill the strange one. He's upset about something.
Yeah, damn it.
For what, though?
I don't know.
He does
something
things strange all the time. Why would he kill him now?
I don't know. But he's very angry, and he was screaming this morning after he walked into the hall.
Well, I go into the hall. I want to make sure my little weird friend is fine.
Okay. So you guys go
I'll
to the hall.
I'll follow them.
Because you're always, yeah.
Just to be clear, I'm just wearing whatever is the equivalent of Viking underpants.
Tighty-whities. Viking tighty-whities.
They're not white.
It might have been at one time.
Teddy grays.
The women that I live with are warriors. I would have to wash my own underwear.
We need a thrall.
You almost said underoos, I think. Underoos.
I think that they're underoos. I think that I killed a kangaroo and I'm wearing its sack as underwear.
Wow.
And you never took the Joey out.
No. Yeah. Wow. A little extra something, something.
Ladies love the dead Joey.
I think that was a World War II thing. Anyway.
It's a Friends thing. I saw that episode.
you guys, you know, there's this, you know, big congregation of people at the opening of the hall. And your friend here has been drugged into the hall. He's in his sleeping clothes. And on the table is this really huge black bag with this like oozing stuff coming out of it.
Black bag.
And hold on.
That's the name of our
Jarl
show.
The Jarl says, shut up. Jesus. The Jarl says, open it.
What is this?
Open
father?
It.
All right. I will.
When you touch it, you feel, you see blood. Fucking open it now.
All right, no need for profanity, Father. So I open it.
It's Uder's head.
Oh, this is a little small.
Who is Uder?
Your friend.
Otar.
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 Otar. What is this?
It's my son.
No, that's not possible. We spoke just last night. There's
yes, you
what
spoke
happened?
To him, and now he is dead.
Yes, but what happened? Where was he found?
If I knew what happened, I wouldn't have you here stuttering like an idiot.
Father, where was he found?
He was found here in this bag in this hall.
Where is the rest of him?
We don't know yet. You're gonna find him.
Orin, what are you implicating? That this little weak one could have killed your son?
No, I'm implicating that this one is strange with magic.
He has no magic.
Everything he touches turns to shit, and you know it. Ever since he's been here, he's been a curse on the family. And now my only son is dead. And I want to know why.
That is an honorable question. There's no need to bring him through the streets.
I'm sure
he's crying
part
softly
of it.
By the bag.
See, now he's crying softly by a bag.
Sorry, I just.
He was your brother. Well, in your
look,
mind.
I don't care. I'm the Jarl, and I say you are going to find the rest of his body, and you're going to find who did this. You understand?
Yes
is the only answer I want.
Yes, Father.
Good.
Jarl, just so You know, we found a claw last night.
I pull it out of my underoos.
With the Joey attached.
It was attached to the wall.
Gross. Mm.
He was obviously sleeping at that time. You know him.
I don't think he could kill anyone. His arms are too weak.
That's what I'm saying.
But
he's so weak.
He's a curse, though. You know he's a curse. He's bad luck.
Wait, where
I've never experienced this.
Where did you find this?
In the wall outside of the hall.
Last night?
There was a large scratch on the outside of the door.
And yes, it was last night.
Anfroy and I heard some strange creature outside.
Wait,
last night.
Someone stranger than your weird thrall?
Well, something large making strange noises.
It could have been a bear.
It was probably a bear.
It was making no sound like a bear. I heard.
He pulls the head out of the bag, and blood comes down. He says, "The cuts are not of an animal. Look at it. It's a perfect cut. An animal didn't do this," and it's just blood's coming down.
Is it a perfect cut?
Yeah.
Jarl, allow me to go in search and find who killed your son.
I don't care if all of you do it. I just want answers.
Yes, Birna is very capable. She's known throughout the...
I know who she is. Shut up. You're still... Be quiet.
He's right. You should shut up.
Look, find out where the rest of my son is so that we can put him on a barge and send him on his way. Understand?
Yes.
Understood.
It will be done.
All right. Where did you find this bag?
Right here. He puts the head back in.
Could it be our enemies trying to send us a message?
That was my first thought, yes. There might be one of the albino's men in the camp, and we wouldn't know.
What is an albino?
It's a person who has no pigmentation in their skin.
Idiot, it's just his nickname. I don't think he's an actual albino. It's just what they call him. Like, I don't drink blood, but I'm the blood drinker.
Well, there was that one time.
The point
drink
is...
One blood.
You drink one blood. Two bloods at the most. Okay.
I'm gonna go put on pants. Let's meet back here.
Don't worry, y'all. Your son will be avenged.
Go and find.
Okay. Can I take the claw?
Yes.
Come on, Grimur.
Grimur.
Whatever.
Grimur.
All right, so you guys leave the Jarl, and he slams the door to the hall, and you hear furniture being thrown and whatnot.
You think it was a party in there?
I'm sorry to have dragged you all into this.
It's not your fault. We know that.
Obviously, the news of the Jarl's son's death spreads quickly, and people are very, you know, shocked and saddened by it. What do you guys want to do?
And go to his house first.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I'm assuming he had his own house, like Greenview.
Yeah, but it's like literally right next to, it's pretty close to the Jarl. So you guys go over there, you know.
I want to inspect the claw on the way.
Okay. It's a really thick claw. To you, it doesn't look like a bear claw. It's a little too flat. It's not completely flat, but it's very sharp. Sharper than... what you've seen in bear claws before.
Okay.
So it would cut through wood pretty good. It's completely black, but it there's no dirt or anything. Like, there's nothing encrusted in the behind it.
Okay.
You know? It's like I said, it's very strong, and it's about this long, so it's a good size of it.
Did you clean this, Magnus?
I mean, if you count putting it in my underwear.
I don't.
Then no.
Okay.
Grimur, What was going on the last time you saw him?
Atar offered to help me with sparring practice this morning.
I'm sorry.
No, I completely understand. I told him as much, but he insisted it would make him feel better.
We all have that good friend that's just a dick.
And where did he go after you saw him?
I don't know. He left. I lost sight of him. I left early last night. I don't like crowds.
Well, I guess we should go to his house first, right?
That's what I said.
That's why we're on the way to his house.
I'm literally fighting my way through this fucker.
Here, seriously, it's way better with 7
up. It's way better with 7 up. A lot of 7 up.
It's an up thing, man.
Mead, it's much better with 7 up.
Unless it's Chaucer's mead.
We're super high class people. Wine and 7 up. From a horn.
That's how you make wine spritzers, right?
Wow, that is a lot better.
Yeah, see? It's way better with 7 up. Anyone else want some 7 up for their terrible mead?
All right, well, I have to try this terrible.
I mean,
it's not good.
I drink.
It's not good. We're telling you.
Know.
You are warned. Here, try it first without 7 up.
I will.
And then try it with 7 up and tell us, is that not a huge improvement?
I mean, it does look like it looks like someone's urine if they've never drank water.
It does.
It's not bad.
It's not, but now try it with 7 up.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, yeah.
Aftertaste, yeah.
Yeah.
It hits you and it freaks you out. It's like, oh, this is a bit, oh my God.
It's not bad at all.
Let's see.
I recommend like 3 parts 7 up, half a part mead.
That's not enough parts.
That's really not a thing.
Half a part?
Half a, like,
pretty sure it should be.
I see.
3/4 of a part.
He's just tricked you, so you could drink more of that. It has to be gone, or we could just leave it for Phoenix Dawn.
There's not very much left.
We could pour it out in the sink.
All right, no? Yeah, you look it over. It hasn't been cleaned.
Put 7 up in it.
Okay. But other than that, nothing. Yeah. Nothing.
There's no evidence of.
No.
I climb up on the roof.
On the Arl's Sun's roof. Okay. Yeah, you get up there. Give me a spot hit and roll.
Spot. The hidden. Spot.
39 over my 25.
Okay. So, yeah, no. You don't see anything. You're still. Did you go home and get on pants?
Yeah.
Okay, I just want to make sure. You're up there.
We're all wearing pants.
I mean,
now.
It wouldn't be the first time the village has seen everything.
Yeah. And you know what? But they wouldn't really care.
I'm
either.
A virile 25-year-old man.
The village wouldn't care. They'd be like, oh, he's naked again. Magus is naked again.
He's up there with his underoos.
Joey just flapping in the wind. This is actually a lot better with 7 up.
I know, right?
That's an ingredient that needs to now be on there, 7 up.
We'll call that the Black Bag Vikings cocktail. Terrible mead and 7 up.
Chat's asking if what the donation cost is on mead shots with no additives.
The
mead's gone.
It's gone. Sorry, Chad.
This
yeah, it's gone.
It's gone.
We can add that for next week. I will buy some more.
Oh, God. Of the terrible one?
Yeah.
So they want us to take straight shots of the terrible mead?
Yes. Of course.
I thought we were friends.
I will do
I've
this.
I've been doing that.
I will do this just for donations.
That's true.
I will get us Malort.
Smirnoff ice.
What is Malort?
I will buy us Malort.
Oh, no.
No.
Wait.
It sounds
terrible.
And we will do shots of Malort.
No, that doesn't even sound like a real word.
Donations.
What is Malort?
Oh, it is apparently the worst alcohol.
It's a Chicago alcohol.
No.
Malort,
it's a Chicago
Malort
alcohol.
Sounds like the sound you'd make after drinking it.
I
Malort it everywhere.
Everyone, that is exactly how you sound. I encourage everyone on chat to look up Malort and then suggest what you would pay to see us?
I will give up drinking entirely before I would take part in that scheme.
Malort? M-O? How's it spelled?
Evil M-A-L?
M-A-L.
Yeah, yeah.
M-A.
Mal, so it's, good. Yeah, it's gotta
O-R-G.
Be.
Mm.
Okay.
It's like my friend who brought a 40-ouncer of laser beer.
Jepson's Malort?
Yep, Jepson's Malort.
It says it's not for the faint of heart.
Hold on, what is laser beer?
Yeah. Yeah.
It'll fuck you up.
It's really cheap beer.
This literally says things you didn't know about Malort. Chicago's bad tasting, something, something, something.
No.
There's literally a phenomenon called Malort face.
Oh, God.
It's the face you take
like
after.
Beverly?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Anyway,
so, let's get back
to this.
So my Joey is flapping in the wind.
And you're looking up there and you can't see anything.
Do I see anything up there? Like even in the distance?
No. Well, give me a roll because you were looking at the
Yeah, I was looking at the roof.
It's Swedish.
I'm going to say no.
Okay, so yeah, no.
Yeah, 94.
I'm going to look around the building.
Sure.
A nine.
Nice.
I see everything.
You notice that there are these weird tracks in the mud. It's three toes, like, sticking out like this, right? And then some kind of weird back claw thing.
It's almost like bird track?
Almost like a bird track. Like a chicken or something. Like a, you know. But they're like this big.
Holy crap.
They're pretty big.
That's a big bird.
That's a big chicken. They're all around. And then you see little marks on the wall of scratches, but no claw like they found at the hall.
Grimier.
Yes?
Come here.
Okay.
And I show you the track.
Okay.
What does that look like to you?
Is that natural world?
Yeah.
61 over my 50.
It looks like scratches.
The bird track does?
The bird track looks like bird tracks. Big bird track.
Looks like some sort of big bird track.
That's what it looks like to me, but I've never seen a bird that size.
Nor I.
Okay. That's what you find on the outside of the...
Which way? Are the tracks leading anywhere?
Well, they go up to the house and then disappear. So you guess because he had mentioned that he had heard someone on the roof.
That it must have gone.
That it must have went up on the roof. But the tracks end. The mud doesn't go up. It's kind of strange.
Magnus, are there any big bird tracks on the roof?
None that you can see.
I don't see any.
Strange.
No.
Anything inside the house? The hut?
You guys go inside the house, and there is everything has been kind of broken apart. He had some furniture, more than most people do, and his bed's broken apart. There was a fight. He obviously, his sword has blood on it, and it's across the room. Obviously, he got hit or something, and his sword went the other way. There is a large pool of blood near the front of the house. You think that's where he possibly was decapitated.
Where's his body?
It's not there.
Being a berserker, I would taste the blood to see if it's human.
Yes.
I taste the blood to see if it's human.
Well, you're not sure, though, because human blood is kind of tastes like chicken, so...
I mean, that is true.
What?
It's either human or chicken.
Or chicken.
That's the two things it could possibly
be. It could be.
I see.
Or whatever pain. That beer you were talking about was.
Or Malort. Malort doesn't taste anything like blood. Guys.
Blood is so much better than Malort.
There's no taste like Malort.
Is it something
like
that
Malort.
Like you wish tasted like blood so it would be slightly better? Because that's horrifying.
It means wormwood. It's Swedish. It means worm. It's a schnapps.
And it's bitter.
It's bitter schnapps.
So probably just like Beverly.
Ugh. It tastes like
Beverly.
Not Beverly.
Tastes like Beverly.
Grapefruit and pencil
Beverly.
Shaping.
Beverly.
Beverly.
It tastes like Beverly.
Yeah. Beverly.
Beverly is
my Italian Coca-Cola soda, whatever.
Yeah.
Beverly.
Somebody really hated a woman named Beverly at some point and made a horrible tasting drink after.
That'll show her.
That'll show her.
Beverly.
Is there anything from the stories that is in any way close to...
A cult roll for me?
Sure.
Is this rooster? You did it.
I
terribly.
Made it.
You lommeled it.
You lommeled it. You made it.
I made it.
You've heard of... you've heard of talks of from... roost stories of... you know, possible, possibly this large building with chicken feet on it. There are stories about a witch that lives in the woods.
Fucking Baba Yaga.
But you also know that story is the place is a lot bigger. The it's a hut on top of chicken legs, and the legs are really, really large. You think that the
proportions much bigger tracks.
Yeah, the proportions are off, but that's the only one you know.
Could be a cabin with very skinny legs.
It could be a tiny home.
Tiny home. Baba Yaga's retirement plan.
She's downsizing.
I just want to buy a tiny chicken leg.
Baba Yaga.
She wants.
I just want to travel around.
She wants to live in 150 square feet.
I'm retired. I don't need a whole lot. Just one tiny hut on chicken legs.
Right. And with a toilet that composts. So that's really what she's
and
looking
a stove
for.
Just big enough for the smallest of child.
All toilets compost.
Yeah, exactly.
True.
And our shower.
Why does your shower compost?
What?
What?
No, all toilets are shower as well. Mm.
Yes. I mean, all showers are toilets.
Actually, the Vikings were...
No.
Actually, the Vikings took more baths than the Europeans did. I mean, the
Southerners.
The Southerners did.
Because they do a lot more work.
I have a point of clarification. Uh-huh. I'm not sure I understand this correctly. Rerolls can only be given to you, but
yes.
pushes can be given to them.
Okay. Yes.
Pushes are the new reroll for the players.
They're the dark and gritty version of rerolls.
So if they miss a push, here's how a push works.
It's like the John Wick of rerolls.
The John Wick of rerolls. So if they say, I'm going to push this roll and they miss it, something bad happens. So it's kind of an edgier, it's more of an Iron Age comic books version.
Someone shot our dog.
Yes. Whoa.
It's like, you know, when you're a teenager and you first get into Skinny Puppy.
Me too.
That's pushes.
I just totally did a drinking faux pas.
Yeah, I've been shooting it up onto my
liquidly?
Face multiple times. Liquid I don't know how to drink from a horn.
I lommeled it. Lama lama. All right, so.
Okay,
now.
So apart from thinking it's a tiny Baba Yaga house, that's all I got.
But you know, there definitely doesn't look anything natural. You fear that it might be your thrall has told you about demons. Your thrall used to work in a monastery, and
you stole a priest.
I didn't.
We stole a priest.
Yeah, we did. You're welcome.
You're welcome for your slave.
He was a gift.
He was a gift. He talks about demons you know, hell. With you.
Silly on front.
He tells you about, you know, different things from his religion. You know, and you also know that there are trolls and other creatures.
We all know
troll.
That.
Yeah, that are probably a little closer to what you think is out there. The Bard 1971 gives you guys three pushes.
Yay! Thanks, the Bard.
Did I give you three?
I think you gave us two.
Woohoo!
Forsaken is also adding three more pushes in the
bank.
Okay.
Yay! Thank you guys.
Pushes.
Pushing.
All the pushes.
I've got nine. You're going to have to drive home because I smell like mead now because I've spilt it all over me like a moron.
Yeah, but police officers don't know what that smells like.
Sir, you smell like a hipster. Get out of your
Get off your penny farthing.
Get out of your Prius. Put your hands against your Prius and you're done. Okay, so.
What the fuck is this?
It's a push token.
It's a push
token. Chat buys those for us so that we can push.
Yeah, but this one looks weird.
So this is what you found. You found the stuff outside. You found the blood and the destruction inside.
Hazard.
But you don't see anything, like there's no movement, like.
There's no tracks
there's
away.
There's no tracks away or anything.
Could it have flown?
Well, if it is a bird, that would make sense.
But what happened to the body?
Well, maybe it.
Perhaps
he
it took
ate
it with him.
It's an animal.
It could also have eaten.
It could be a rather large raven.
We should find it,
I
and we can kill it.
Find that unlikely.
Well, for Otar's honor, we need to find his body so he
Otar.
Can.
I love it. Thank you. It wasn't me this time. Anyway, go ahead.
Otar.
Yeah. Utter.
You know, I like you, here's but you're wearing thin.
You're only saying that just now.
Sorry.
How many exits and entrances are there into the city?
There's only one. There's no health code here.
And this thing probably did not come from the sea.
Here?
Yeah.
No, it's not a chicken of the sea.
It is not tuna fish.
Charmed.
Chicken of the sea.
I say that we go out through the one entrance and see if we can find more of these tracks.
Okay. Oh, you mean the, for the, yeah, there's, I thought you meant the building.
No, of the town.
Of the
there's,
town.
There's on each, there's the main one right here, down right. here. There are ways to get out over here, but they're not as big as this particular exit.
Like, so that would be the only way a chicken house could get out?
Yes, or a large cart
Should
or
we
something.
Not question whoever was on guard last night and see if they perhaps saw anything entering?
That's why I like you. Always thinking.
Okay, so you guys go talk to the guards?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you guys go up to the guardhouse, and...
I'll do the questioning.
Okay.
I kick down the door.
Will you stop?
Probably could have knocked.
Gris looks at you and goes, Scott, what are you doing? Don't
you
knock.
See something weird last night?
I was not... Okay.
Oh, you weren't on last night?
No, and when
Who
I came
was on
in,
duty?
Oi...
it's a juice slave.
Orin was on last night.
Orin was on? The no, Jarl
no.
was on?
No, Orin, not...
Orin, not Orin. Not,
no.
Oh. Sorry, I've been in the Berserkers for so long, my ears.
His ears.
His ears. No, he didn't report anything weird. Why? What are you guys looking for?
You didn't hear any noises.
The rain and thunderstorm made it very difficult.
Maybe like a small house on bird legs?
He's been saying this the entire time.
Just
I have
ignore
no
him.
Idea what that means.
Just ignore
just
him.
A large bird.
You're the only person that knows that's even a possibility, like that's an occult thing.
Right, yeah.
Because it's not really well known.
I know, Greece.
Oh, wow. Okay. Texas Devon gives you guys 6 pushes.
Texas Devon.
Nice. Thank you, Texas Devon.
Wow.
That's a lot of pushes. I'm going to have to start making you guys push.
We should start
push.
Rolling for
push
things.
Woo. At this point, I'd like to...
Oh, man. Stop drinking.
So I got all the re-rolls, and if you leave the rest up when they get into,
yeah,
you know...
Yeah, I figured.
Yeah. All right.
I'd like to channel some of my... knowledge to okay. try to like figure out what to do next. I'm very intelligent, not very smart, but very intelligent.
Right. So give me an idea roll.
6.
6. Wow.
Wow.
Under my 70.
Okay.
Well, the idea.
So you're
beep.
You know that the road into town is relatively treacherous with the ice and the and it still hasn't melted all that much. And it, if it had come this way, mm-hmm. you guys would find tracks. Mm-hmm. So your best bet, mm-hmm. if it has flown in, is maybe go down the road a little bit mm-hmm. and see if you run into where its tracks are. Maybe it walked a little bit in, flew in, and then flew out and walked out.
I feel like if this thing's a bird, since we don't see tracks here, we should go further out. It might have flown in.
Well, it also, if it is the same creature that was outside my house, it did climb.
Climb? So, or
did
perched?
It climb on your roof, or did it jump up there?
That's what I said. Mir.
Not sure. Oh.
If we're going to be traveling far, we should get horses.
Yes, and some supplies together.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
Father says horses are for the weak who we pillage and take their offerings.
It is it is actually funny because there are not many mentions of horses in Vikings.
Supposedly they used them mostly for farming. They didn't use them for
riding. They didn't use them for riding.
Okay, then we would just walk.
Just walk.
I say we should use horses.
What
I think
a weird suggestion.
I'm just saying, I'm good with them.
Father said
I can ride them well.
Birna,
we're not tilling
do
fields.
Us no good in the mountains.
Fine, but it
if
might.
This is a large bird,
call her young girl. Young girl, you listen.
If this is a large bird,
which it probably is,
it has to nest somewhere.
Hmm. And there's no trees around here because I cut them all down.
To make
well, there aren't enough large enough for a bird that size. So we have to go up the mountain. That is my thought.
I wish you well.
No, you're
oh,
coming
you are,
with.
You're coming with us. Oh.
You think your father will let you stay here?
But mother said I was not to leave the
if your mother stay in Stavanger, you will die. Well, you do know this.
I know the places to hide from father when he's...
We need your
intelligence. Your father has never lost his son before.
True.
She's right. You have to come with us. You have no choice. You have to be
You'll
brave
be
at some
safe.
Point.
You have often been the object of his anger.
This is a good point to this is a good point to point out, point blah blah. The Viking way. Cowardice is not the Viking way. So they would definitely be like, the pressure to not be a coward and not to be what you, you know, the weak, like, I can't use a sword. That's a big disadvantage in the culture. I'm just letting you know that and just, you know, I'm not saying you're playing the character wrong. I'm just saying
I will, here, hold one of my axes.
What's your strength?
I actually have a strength of 60.
Okay, so you're above average.
But my dex is very low. I have a slight palsy in my.
Okay.
In my hands.
Okay.
Whoa. And to be fair, my axes are extremely heavy.
Yeah, it's as big as I am.
Yes. Okay. Cool. All right. So
you cannot shy away from this. Well, he will kill you.
Shall I drag this then?
Holy hell.
Well, it would make you stronger.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What?
I know.
What?
Me?
Sorry, I just snuck a look at Megan's.
Oh, they're both ridiculous.
I'm huge.
No,
you're not huge.
And I'm strong.
You're one of the strongest people ever.
Ever.
Where is my size?
You're seven,
she's only a 75.
That's
oh,
pretty
huge
big.
For
I'm a
woman.
I'm an 80.
So she's almost as big as you are.
That's true.
And
but
I'm 17.
Her strength is
she's
90.
She's a growing girl.
Would you like to go to prom?
My strength
too bad
is only
you are
16.
Chosen.
And
my
you know what my name
was?
Snoo Snoo will be fun
female
with you.
Bear. That's what my name means. Female bear.
My name means big strong one.
There you go. We are a very strong family.
My name means disguised.
Also, this is what I look like. I'm 25 years old.
Just the young 25-year-old.
Go to Dice Cam.
Oh, sorry.
Nick.
Leave Nick alone.
There you go.
And
we're talking about Free Jack over here. I don't have time for you.
Oh, I'm sorry, chat. We can talk about Free Jack.
So
Emilio Estevez was the best.
So you guys start off and you go down the road a few miles, right? And automatically, both of you, the three of you, get a sense that you're being watched. And the hairs on the back of your neck kind of...
Can I pull out my sword?
Nice day, all things considered.
Shh.
What?
Shh.
What?
Shh.
And suddenly...
Be quiet.
Seven men come yelling out of the woods... And surround you.
Seven.
Only seven.
We can take them.
All right. Starting with you, what's your dex again?
35.
Oh, Jesus.
All right. What's your dex?
65.
Okay. What's your dex?
60.
Okay. And your dex?
55.
Okay. So.
Well, it's been fun, guys.
Green mode. Dead.
Surround the weak one.
Mystic needs food badly. okay. Wow, that's going to be difficult. Tell me your pro and con again.
Reputation. Basically, it's just either my reputation precedes me in a bad way or positive way.
Okay, cool.
And it could have something to do with my mother, too, I mean, however.
And
she has a reputation as well.
For being a whore.
What?
What? She's my sister, I can say that.
Your berserker's being, you get a token.
Berserker.
Forsaken. Forsaken gives you a token for berserker.
Oh, fuck you. I mean, thank you, but I have no idea what this is going to be.
You have no idea whether or not it's good or bad.
Thank you or fuck you.
What is your pro if your berserker's a pro?
If my berserker's a pro, I get an advantage on my combat rolls.
And if it's a negative?
If it's a negative, I get a hard. Yeah, all of my rolls are hard.
Okay, cool. So these guys are around you, and you don't recognize them. They are not from your town. They are not wearing the things that would identify them as, you know, locals or anything like that. You've never seen them before.
Do they look albino?
No, they don't. That's just a nickname.
How pale are they?
It's just a nickname.
It's a nickname.
I don't know what it means.
You'll learn. They're surrounding you. Let's see. Actually, Megan, can you roll a percentile die for me? What'd you get?
34.
All right. All right. And then roll one more time.
61.
Okay, cool. All right, so 3 and 4. All right. So, Megan, you are first.
Okay.
What do you want to do? How do you want to respond?
So, they've come out. Are they surrounding us?
They came out on both sides and are kind of surrounding you in a semicircle on both sides.
Do they look threatening?
Yes, they do.
Do they have weapons?
They do.
I just pulled my sword, so I have that out.
Right.
But I would have a shield.
Yeah. Just so real quick, so I can go over shield. Okay. So shield can be used instead of defense. So you can, and you should have a shield stat. If you do not, you can spend points on having a shield score. I believe I gave you one.
60.
Of 60, okay. Oh. You guys can take shield at 60 as well, because you are, you might want to do like 50 because you're younger.
Sure.
But you would be like a 60 as well. Yeah. You can also do a shield bash, which is an attack. Okay. And it does 1d3 plus your... plus your damage bonus, okay?
Okay.
So that's all that. You don't have a shield, I don't think.
I don't have anything.
You don't have anything. Okay. Don't leave the homestead without a weapon.
I tried not to.
Yeah, it didn't work very well. All right, so you're first. And what do you want to do?
I'll probably say... you dare challenge us, and and then, I mean, if they're surrounding us, I'll probably try and attack
the closest one.
Closest one. Okay. My sword.
So as you're swinging your sword at him, he gets a smirk in his eye, and you realize that your reputation has preceded you in a bad way.
Ruh-roh.
Oh no.
Thank you, BSB Care.
Thanks, BSB Care.
So these people know your reputation, and they're not really impressed by you.
Would I recognize them?
You don't recognize them, no. But they recognize you.
And I recognize that they recognize me?
Now, yes.
Okay. Looks like they want to make a name for themselves.
Yeah, taking down the young
the largest
fighter.
Woman in the world.
Yes, very large and strong. Oh,
she's a growing girl.
I am. Oh, I see. I see. You must have. Which town are you from? Are you from the one where I
saved? Stop talking and fight.
Oh, okay, fine. I will, and I will swing with my sword And that is a 44 under my 75.
Jesus Christ.
All right, so they're going to try to use their shield. So you...
I am the best!
Did you even try? That looked like you intentionally were just like, I give up.
Wow.
Hold on. Wow, I don't think he needs any more of that, actually.
Seven!
A seven.
What?
So you swing down and he... hits your axe or sword?
Sword.
Sword aside, and goes like this across, just tries to hit you.
My S word.
13.
Ooh, 13.
Yep. What the?
Can someone make him change his dice, please?
Okay.
All right.
Do I dodge? I don't understand.
Or shield.
Wait, I was attacking, so he was blocking.
He was blocking, and he hit, because he goes not far after you.
Okay.
He's
oh, I see.
So he swings at you. Now you can defend, but he rolled really well. So you're gonna have to roll really well.
So would I? Okay. So do I just use dodge for this?
Or you can use dodge, or you can use shield.
I'll use my shield then, because it's way better.
Now your shield only has 15 hit points. Once your shield takes 15 hit points, it breaks apart.
I get new shield.
It's up to you guys, though. Okay. I mean, 15 hit points is a person.
I'll use
It's like having your thrall.
It's like better hit points than me.
It's
right?
More person than me,
It's more person than me.
It's a 77.
Jesus.
Over my 50.
With pushes.
No, you can't use pushes in combat.
I feel like we should be able to use
pushes. Did we change that?
Because
we're only doing pushes.
Oh, right. But if you
miss the push,
but we have 27 pushes.
Yes. I know.
But I think you can only use one push per roll.
Yeah. No, that's absolutely true.
Dark and gritty.
Dark and gritty. New characters
every
week.
Should I do it? Oh, yeah. Man, I like Birna. All right.
Then use your shield. No.
I'll try it.
All right.
Oh, come on.
I mean,
you definitely did.
13!
Woohoo! All right, reroll. No, just kidding. So your shield will take the damage, though.
Okay.
So they're swinging us.
Wait, did his shield take damage?
Yes, his shield takes damage.
Well, good.
How much damage?
How much? She has to roll. Why does it keep popping out?
Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
What is going on?
Three damage.
So three damage to the shield.
To my shield? Okay.
Yeah, to the shield.
I'll put it over here.
All right.
And then do you roll for shield damage?
Yeah, you need to roll for shield damage as well.
So I roll 1d3. Wait.
No. What is sword damage?
Oh, sword damage?
It's 1d. I believe it's 1d6 plus her. Plus one plus her.
Damage bonus.
So she could literally crush a shield.
What is her damage?
What is my damage?
It's in the corner. It should be in the corner there. It auto does it. It's on the bottom.
Oh, plus 1d6.
Plus 1d6. Is it plus 1d6?
Yeah.
Wow, she is strong.
So wait, I rolled 2d6 plus one?
Yeah.
Wow.
You are. You could literally break a shield with one hit.
Yes, I could. Six?
So that's pretty, yeah. Like wood splinters off the shield. All right, so
I smirk at him.
That first guy got his attack. There are three others. One of them is going to go after you. The other is going to go after you, and the last one will go after you as well, Megan. Okay, so we're going to start with you.
Okay.
All right. So let's see. All right. That's a, well, that one's kind of cocked, isn't it?
No. I'm going to say yes.
That's a six. So unless you roll incredible, what are you going to use, your shield or your?
I was going to use my shield.
To defend, okay. Mm-hmm. So you just have to do your shield percentage and you have to be better than what I did.
51 under my 60.
So, yeah, no. You swing your shield around just short and you know, it doesn't happen. Do you want to push or no? It's pretty low. I'm just saying it's a 6%. Okay, I should just stay up. Oh, Jesus. So, 6 points.
Ooh.
You get tagged.
My shield gets tagged. I failed my shield.
You get, yeah.
Jeez. Starting this off right.
Are we doing the hit points on the...
Yeah.
She just got... tagged for 6 points of damage.
Okay. Okay.
So I'm at 6 out of 12.
Yeah, so you take half, so...
She's at 6.
Out of 12. You can buy hit points, just saying.
I feel like for this campaign, we're going to need a lot of hit points.
A lot of hit points are going to have to happen.
I don't know how to fight.
That's going to be kind of a problem.
You're a Viking.
He's not a Viking.
No, Father says I'm an embarrassment.
Megan, we're going to do Jordan last because this might be his only fight.
Yeah, is no one fighting
No one's gone after you yet. There's seven people. Oh. This is the first set of people that are going, and then the next set. So.
I see.
All right.
I'll take the three.
This mead.
All right, ready?
It's pretty strong.
It's pretty strong. It is.
Knocked me out.
That's why I keep throwing the dice out of the goddamn thing.
Oh, sure.
All right, so, no, I'm a total lightweight, so yeah.
You probably feel about it like I do.
Yeah.
I don't know what would happen if I stood up.
So,
let's see.
And nope. I keep having to stand up, which is not fun. So I rolled a 27. So you need to make a decision on whether it's a defense roll or a shield roll.
So if it's a defense roll, I'm dodging.
You're dodging, right.
See, my dodge isn't as
good. Yeah, you can do shield.
So, shield. Yep, 13.
Okay, ooh, so yeah, so you're fine.
My best friend, Shield. I call her.
His name is Shield.
Three more points to your shield.
Okay. Well.
Okay. Thunk.
People name their swords, why not their shields?
Right?
So.
Gertrude.
So that was the last attack on you. This guy's coming up towards you. You're like looking around. You've got a few guys behind you. And right as he swings, this woman from the village puts herself between you and this guy attacking you.
Oh, it's a sexy one.
Exactly who it is.
It's a sexy one.
Actually.
Actually. Uh-oh, it's not the sexy one, I guess.
Oh, no, she might be sexy.
It is. Who's this?
It's that masked vigilante I keep hearing about.
This is Jarl Jr.'s famous star gave us this one.
Wow.
And it's Shield Maiden Bjork.
Bjork?
Bjork.
Bjork.
Not so, wearing a swan? Yeah. Is she wearing swan armor?
She has a swan on her shield.
That's because she's awesome.
But Bjork is pretty
I don't really get her.
I've heard of her.
So she gets between
to her you. Multiple times.
Can you do a dex, Jordan? Can you do a dex check to see if you fall back at all, or if you keep your footing?
Probably. I fall back all the way.
This is not going to be good.
Oh man!
So you fall. You fall on your back.
Mother was right.
And you hit the mud. And she's standing there, just fighting with this guy.
He could have gone for Carl, Junior, because there's a Carl.
Yeah, but Jarl, that's the joke.
Eh? She misses. Okay, but she's between you and him. All right. So now.
Thank you, Bjork.
That brings us
to. I like
to
the one where she dances with a bear.
She's very brave.
That's my favorite dream.
Ben, it's your turn. What do you want to do?